Alright, good morning guys. There's been a change of plans, but I don't know how well it's gonna go over. So basically last night I got here and they told me that the load would be ready at 6 p.m. tonight, so I slept in a little bit. But when I woke up, they had unassigned the load and gave me a different load. But this place is about an hour away from here. And it's a live load, and it was scheduled for 5 p.m. Well, it's currently 5 p.m. right now. So, I looked up their hours, and it says they close at 11 at night. So, we're going to try to see if this place will release the empty bag to us. Hopefully a different one, because the trailer doors on that other one were, like, really being a pain. Hopefully they'll give us a different empty, but we're going to go see if they'll let us pick up an empty or not. I have a feeling they may not, which would be absolutely stupid because it's not my fault they rescheduled that load. But yeah, so we need to go down here, check in with the guard, and be like, just sweet talking pretty much. Hopefully they just release an empty to us, and hopefully it's not the same one, but if it is the same one, then okay, I guess. But we're gonna get checked in and all that. Far so good, they assigned us an empty here in the yard. It's all the way at the end, but it's a 3-5 number, and I have a feeling it might be a super single trailer. So I was like, if it's a super single, you know, can I come back and get a different one? Because, like, dude, sliding the tandems on I guess the speed limit's 15. I was like, dang, we're kind of moving, but sliding the tandems on a super single tire trailer is actually, like, so hard, dude. Like, it's just so annoying. So so we're looking for this empty over here. It's like 3-5 something, but it should be in 4099. So we're in the 60s right now, so we got about another 30 spots to go down. And that mirror's faced at the ground, so I'm gonna have to fix that once I get a trailer hooked up. 81. So basically the next CFI we see is gonna be the one we're supposed to grab. So 93, 94, 95, 96, 99, and here it is. It's a super single. I can already tell you that. Yep, she's a super single. I guess super single doesn't matter. If it's not the lever, then it's fine. But if it's the lever, then it's not fine. Let me go look. Because I'll take it if it's just the, you know, but if it's a lever, it looks like it's a lever. So I'm gonna have to call that guy. Cause I'm not dealing with it. Look, it's at the rear, and now super singles are not easy to slide. Yeah. All right. I'm gonna call him, see if I can get a different trailer, cause I don't want to deal with it. Super singles. So anyway, we are finally got an empty. We got a 5 series, so it's pretty new. It's also a Hyundai trailer. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing that right. I'm sure I'm not. I'm sure I'm butchering it. But so we got this trailer. And we're headed to North Carolina. Hopefully they don't take too long to load us. They close at 11, it says, so hopefully they can get me in at 6:30. Chad said he was gonna get back to me, but he gets off at 5. Oh, I guess it's only 4 there. It's 4:30 now. Okay. I thought he was getting off work soon, but I guess it's gonna be faster for me just to head down that way. So that's what we got going on now. And hopefully they just load us, and then I wish there was a drop and hook at the Walmart, because if it was, I guess I couldn't make it there tonight, but I could be there by tomorrow, and it's not due till the 12th, so I'm not really in any sort of hurry to get down there now, I guess, because it's only like 620 miles, and it's due Sunday, and so there probably won't be a video tomorrow. When this comes out, there probably won't be a video the next day, because, I mean, there might, I guess, because we'll probably, well, It really is gonna do us no good to drive like 400 or 500 miles. Like, we're not gonna be able to find parking on the East Coast. This is why this kind of sucks. I guess it depends on how long it takes for them to load us at the other place. I guess that's a good point. I wonder how many people are sitting in these docks, or not these people, but I wonder if that trailer that was sitting in the dock that I was supposed to pick up is done yet. Let's see, it ends in 17. I forgot what the actual trailer number was, though. Yeah. He's picking it up right now, so it's done. See, I don't understand. Like, even if it wasn't due till a day later, like, I could have relayed that in Joplin, but now I gotta go get loaded somewhere else. I don't know. Sometimes some things don't make sense to me. I don't know what it is, man. I don't. So I called back because, like, this trailer said when I entered it on here, it was like load not current. I'm like, what does that mean? You know, so I called to see what that meant. And he's like, oh, your trailer's fine. He's like, I don't know what it's saying. I think they dispatched me with that other trailer that I dropped last night, but the guy's like, yeah, it's already being loaded. So anyways, we're headed towards the shipper, but there are, you know, both my fleet manager and this other guy I just talked to, I was like, yeah, like, see if I can get loaded tonight. You know, he's like, well, if not, you can always get loaded tomorrow morning. Like, I don't know. Do they just not think we're human? Like, how? I just woke up at 5 p.m. today. How am I going to wake up at 8 a.m. tomorrow to go get loaded, bro? Like, I'm not going to be tired. Like, no matter how much I want to go to sleep, I'm not going to be able to. Like, I'm literally wide awake right now. Like, I could literally drive 600 miles right now. No questions asked. Like, just knock it out. So, I don't know. But I guess we're going to go down here. If they're not going to be able to load me, there's probably about a Love's about 20 miles away. Backtrack to that Love's, park, and tell them, like, get me loaded at 1 p.m. tomorrow. Because I'm not going to be able to go get loaded at 8 a.m. I'm just not going to be, like, awake, dude. I'm going to be dog tired, like. So I just hope they can load me tonight. That'll eliminate a lot of problems. Be good to go. Knock out 400 or 500 miles tonight. Night driving down the East Coast. Which can get scary, because there are, like, really tight curves along some interstates, so I don't know, but I haven't been to North Carolina. Last time I was out for 2 months, I didn't go any further west than Ohio, so, or east further than Ohio, and I didn't go any further west than Kansas, so it's kind of nice to get out of this little Midwest region, I'll tell you guys that much, but hopefully you guys enjoyed the last two videos. Like I said, we're back every day as long as I have a load to take. So just down the road from the shipper here, I'm hoping that they'll load me, but my appointment was at 5. It's almost 7. So we're making a right-hand turn here. I think we're probably, you know what, we're going to do this because he's going to pull all the way up. So we're going to come out into this left lane here. Turn right. Watch our trailer. We're good. Cleared it. All right, well, hopefully we can get loaded. I don't know. If not, we got a Love's about 20 miles away from here. I'm just hoping we can get loaded and get out of here, though. So we're going to find out here in just a moment. Hopefully, if we get loaded, you know, we'll be headed towards North Carolina. So we might have to backtrack even to scale. I'm not sure if there's Love's or something along my route that before a weigh station. Or hopefully we're just light. That'd be really sweet, but I doubt it. It's going to a Walmart DC. It's probably like 40,000, which is kind of light, because I mean that gives you a couple thousand pounds on each axle, but still, like 25,000 would be great. I love that. I wouldn't even have to scale it. I don't know. Probably not gonna be able to get loaded, but fingers crossed. Wishful thinking. We're gonna find out here in just a moment. To park before we go check in, so let me go for that one over there. I would just stay here overnight, but I didn't have have to eat. I haven't ate anything today, so. But we're gonna go check in. Hopefully everything's well. Get loaded. Oh. I didn't think I was gonna be sticking out that far. Hopefully I didn't rip off any mud flaps. So this place is definitely a different check-in. Gotta throw that seatbelt on. I always forget when I'm like driving around here. It's definitely different. So I had to text a number. What my load number was, all that stuff. And then they're all like, okay, go to door 72. And they sent me a text back. They're like, go to door 72, slide your tandems all the way to the rear. All this stuff. So I think we gotta go around to the other side of the building because that's only 60. So, but I have no bungee cords on the trailer doors. It's all like just a little metal thing. So the doors kind of sway out a lot, which I hate, but hopefully they don't take too long to load us. And like there's no lights on the door, so like do not move your truck until we send you a text. So I'm like, okay, you know, this is different, never had that happen before. Hopefully I don't have like dyslexia and it was door 12 and I'm going trying to find a door 72. Okay, well there's trailers over here, so it's got to be fine, right? It's got to be fine. Looks like there's a gate to leave over here though. 72 is gonna be like right on the end, I have a feeling. Unless it's all backwards. Oh, no, it's not on the end, but it's pretty middle, so. Pretty easy. So we need to cut it hard left here. There's almost enough room to straight back this. There's plenty of room here, actually. Cut it up here. That's pretty good setup, actually. All right, so need to give it just a little bit right here. Make sure we get up this gate. Now we need to go hard left. Actually, then you go left and straight, and then we're gonna have to give it just a little bit right here. We're gonna have to slide our tandems back. Left again. We're not quite straight with the door. I don't know if you guys can see the line or not. But we also need to slide the tandems. So, alright, we're gonna go ahead and do that right now. One, two. Should be in drive. So they're all the way back. Just need to drive up to the left here. Straighten it. And then it should just be straight back from here. Until we ever so slightly dink the door. And we're going too fast for it to be a little dink here, but. Alright, we'll go chalk the wheel, and then we gotta disconnect our red valve. So, let me do that. Yeah, it looks like we're in the door pretty good. And we just need to chalk it. I honestly did not see one of these. trailer, so, oh, it's there. Hopefully I'm not too close, because some have like old ones and you need to be a little bit off to get it in. But we just gotta disconnect the red line. And I'm gonna shoot him a text saying, wheels chocked, airline disconnected, that way they know I'm here. So we just weighed the truck. We're legal, so we're getting ready to roll here. And these guys kind of made it tough, I'm not gonna lie. Just gotta make sure I clear this curb on my ride over here. Looking good. So we got 16 miles to go, and then we're gonna be able to eat, because I haven't ate anything yet today, and I'm really hungry because I'm in a caloric deficit. Yesterday, nailed it, 1900 calories again. So today is gonna be another 1900 calorie day. We gotta get down to this Love's though, so we can get some food. I was gonna get food at this Pilot, but I don't know. I was sitting behind this guy over here, and I thought he was like inside, but I think he's waiting to get fuel. And I went around him and he tried to like pull up because he thought I was like cutting in front of him, but I just needed a way, so. I hope he didn't think I was going to get fuel, because, you know, that's not the case, but. He's like looking at me like I cut at him, dude. I didn't cut you, like I just weighed my truck, bro. But it is hot, dude. It's hot, what in the heck? Dude, I got it set for 66. It's like hot in here, I don't know what's going on. But we gotta get back on the interstate for 16 miles, hit up this Love's, get some lunch, I guess, cause I mean, and then I think, I don't know, it's supposed to deliver Sunday at 9 a.m., but now it's starting to look like it's gonna deliver Sunday at 6 p.m. So that's an extra, well wait, I was gonna go, but that's an extra 9 hours difference. So that kind of sucks. You know, 9 hours is a lot of time. But hopefully it's still 9 a.m., but on my bills it says 6, and I called CFI, and they're like, well, we think it's 9 a.m. still, but they're like, we'll make sure for you, so. So we stopped at that Love's after we weighed the truck. We had 2 McChickens and a McDouble. Now I know some of you are gonna be like, oh my God, that's so much food, but it's only 1,200 calories, okay? McChickens are 360 calories each, and McDouble is 400. So do the math, 360 times 2, 720 plus 400, 1120 calories. I just go ahead and go up to 1200 though, because it's not exact math every time, you know, like it could have been less calories, or they may have put a little bit extra mayonnaise, so I added an extra 100 calories. So we're at 1200 calories for the day. Now I know like a lot of you are like, geez, that's a ton of food, right? I'll tell you what, if you cut out, now I know someone's gonna say, oh, McDonald's isn't healthy, that's no diet. It's all calories, my people. It's all calories. I can literally eat like, I don't know how many calories, say a Twinkie's 400 calories. I eat 5 Twinkies a day. That's 2000 calories. I'll lose weight if I have just 5 Twinkies a day. I don't know how many calories they are, but If I'm eating 2,000 calories a day, my body will burn about 3,000, 3,200, somewhere in there, every day, even if I just don't do anything. So at 1,900 calories a day, I'm burning 1,300 calories. 1 pound of fat is 3,500 calories. So every 3 days, I'm burning a pound by just eating 2,000 calories without doing any exercise or anything. It's all math, guys. It's all math. So I know like McDonald's isn't the best for a diet, but if the calories are right, I'm gonna lose weight no matter what I eat. Anyways, so yeah, we had 1200 calories, which gives us a couple extra 100 calories to eat for dinner. We probably won't have dinner till like 2 in the morning, to be honest, somewhere in there, 3 in the morning. I guess the speed will move down a little bit. I don't know where we're stopping, but I need to like try to stop at a Love's, because I'm gonna be sitting there for like 30 hours with no pay. Until I can make the delivery for this load. So yeah. Also, I'm gonna speak on a diet again. If you're gonna go on a diet, drink calories count, okay? So say you're eating 2,000 calories worth of food, but then you're having like 3 Pepsis a day. That's 600 calories, dude. You're not really in a caloric deficit. So if you have a craving for soda, drink a diet soda. I know soda's not great for you, but I've been drinking a lot of water. I did get a diet Dr. Pepper with my two McChickens and a McDouble, but I didn't have any soda, so it's like whatever. So yeah, that's something to remember. But yeah, here pretty soon you guys are gonna not even think you're subscribed to the same person. I'm telling you, I know a lot of you think I'm capping right now, but once my mind's truly set on something, I'll do it. So it's gonna take a couple months, and it may not even look like I lost any weight, because you know, like at the deficit I'm in, it's gonna take a little bit to drop some weight off, but it'll happen. I'm telling you guys, it'll happen. Almost heaven, West Virginia. Well, if you guys couldn't tell, we're in West Virginia. We're in West Virginia here. We got 392 miles left until we make it to our drop off, but we only have 210 miles till we need to take a 30 minute break. So it's about 3 hours and 20 minutes, I want to say. This is a pretty weird construction zone. So yeah, I had two choices, left or right lane. I went with the right. I don't know, maybe I should have went with the left. I'm just hoping this doesn't like try to make me take an exit up here. So we're gonna see how that goes. Rumble strips, I'm guessing we're getting ready to merge back to two lane. Yeah, good. So that works out. But yeah, so we've just been driving for, I wanna say like 2 hours and 20 minutes. So yeah, I know you see that the speed limit's 55 and my speedometer says 57, 58. But if you look over at the tablet, it says I'm doing 56 because my speedometer is like off. So whatever, you know, it's just how it goes sometimes. All right, guys, it's 3:30 in the morning. This is the nearest Love's to our stop tomorrow. It's 180 miles away from where we're headed. But we're going to take this. Oh, just cussed. We're going to take this spot right here. All right, let me lift up my armrest here. This is like a perfect spot, dude. All the room in the world. I can smell my brakes though. Sheesh. There's like a huge mountain right there, and the Love's exit was like right there, and I had to just go for it. So I had to hit the brakes pretty hard. So I can kind of smell them a little bit, but that's okay. This is like the nicest parking spot ever for 3 in the morning. Whichever driver just left here, thank you. You probably got here at like 6 p.m. Nah, he probably got here at like 3 in the afternoon. Get as far back as I can. I should, actually. I'm gonna slide it over closer to the curb a little bit. That way, I don't have to worry about getting his hit or getting hit. I'm probably gonna be here for a while. Moved it over about a foot, so this should work here. Definitely gonna be like a little bit like facing towards the, like towards that way, like when I go to sleep, like my body will probably want to roll, but it's whatever, it's a good spot. So if you guys maybe tomorrow, I don't know, I doubt it, because we're pretty much have enough time to do a 34 here. So peace.
Come on, everything is a-okay when you're riding with Jay. Keep those wheels turning, and we do this every day. Backing up a trailer, look at all the roads I've driven. Come and ride with me, yeah, let me show you how I'm living. Come on.